Tesla could potentially make more money from its Bitcoin investment this year than profits from electric cars in all of 2020. What's your take on that? What's your Bitcoin take and the fact that the price can just go up or down based on a simple tweet from him?
Well, look, Elon has tons of money and he's very sophisticated. So, I don't worry that his Bitcoin will sort of randomly go up or down. I do think people get bought into these manias who may not have as much money to spare. So I'm not bullish on Bitcoin. And my general thought would be that if you have less money than Elon, you should probably watch out.
Why aren't you bullish on Bitcoin?
It's look, there are things we invest in society that produce output. Bitcoin happens to use a lot of energy. It happens to promote anonymous transactions. They're not reversible transactions. The Gates Foundation does a lot in terms of digital currency, but those are things where you can see who's making the transaction. So digital money is a good thing. And there's a different approach that's local currency and attributed and deals with all the money laundering and terrorism type regulations, and yet gives you the very the convenience and the low cost of transaction. And so our foundation is very proud that in the pandemic, a lot of the countries we funded to do this were able to get money out to their citizens very, very efficiently. So that's something that it's not got the visibility of Bitcoin, but the move towards digital money that we're very engaged in is a super positive thing that eventually will get to even the poorest countries.
About this idea that you're protecting your capital buying Bitcoin. There is no evidence that it has a reverse correlation to correcting markets. Last March, if you owned Bitcoin, you got slaughtered, and you had a lot more volatility than the S&P. My whole point is there's a lot of interesting ideas here, and certainly the fact that a Bitcoin, all the other ones haven't worked, but Bitcoin has. This concept of a digital currency is one that would work, and my whole point is for all of us, including you, Scott, who monitor and work within the financial services multi-trillion-dollar global industry, is this a nothing burger? It's not even a single-cell amoeba. If you took all of the market cap of Bitcoin, totally irrelevant. I love to talk about it. It's fun to watch it go up and down. But during the day when the bell rings, I don't talk to anybody that's worried about this. They do not put capital to work in Bitcoin. Maybe it's fun if you're an individual high net worth person that wants to just play with it. But the financial markets deal with regulators, and you can only operate within the confines of those rules. And so when we glorify something like this, it really has nothing to do with the financial markets that make the whole world work. And no institutional or sovereign fund investor I've ever talked to has said to me, go index all of the cryptocurrencies for me. And the reason they don't want to own that is they fear the regulator. And watch what happens one day. And I'm waiting for this one. I'm waiting for the day that one of these regulators comes down hard on Bitcoin. Grown men are going to weep when that happens. You'll never see a loss of capital like that ever in your life. It'll be brutal.
Okay,
And I'm just saying you got to get ready for it.
to that
I'm
point.
listen, I'm ready to risk the rest of the I got $52 here. I could lose it all. And I don't know where 1-800, operators are standing by to explain what happened. It's not going to. This is just ether. That's all it is.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.
Elon Musk says Tesla will no longer accept Bitcoin. That announcement really sent the cryptos tumbling. In fact, the crypto valuation lost a third of $1 trillion just overnight. Pete Hegseth joins us. Now, we normally talk to Pete about the business that's going on in the economy and people going back to work or not going back to work, but Pete is a Bitcoin guy. And I want to ask him if he's getting a little nervous when you see a sell-off like this. Are you nervous, Hegseth?
Stuart, you know I'm a bull's bull when it comes to Bitcoin. I am not nervous. I mean, if you think about it, it's only about 25% off the all-time high, and it's been steady in the 50s for quite some time. Seeing Elon Musk make this move, a little surprising. Maybe he's going to allow for Dogecoin instead, which seems to be his favorite cryptocurrency. But I'm more encouraged, Stuart, by the fact that, did you see that Sotheby's allowed a Banksy painting to be purchased for $13 million with cryptocurrency, with Bitcoin? So someone spent 258 Bitcoin to get a rare Banksy painting just today. So on balance, I think acceptance of cryptocurrency is going up. Institutionalizing it is happening. Investors realize it's an option and it's an efficient way to pay for things. Will it be a currency in the near term? Still remains to be seen. Or in the long term, still remains to be seen. But right now, I think we're not seeing a real fall off here. I mean, that would be in the 30s or 40s. Sitting in the low 50s, it took a bit of a hit, but it's better than it racing to 125,000 and everyone feeling like it's a bubble and it's speculative. I think you're seeing real value in its ability to be to maintain its price.
I thought it was a bubble when it went to 64,000, but that's another story entirely, Pete, and we'll discuss it another day.
I think it's a pyramid scheme. It makes no sense. I'm just surprised that it isn't even lower.
So you're in the Jamie Dimon school, or his previous school. He's shifted positions lately.
Well, I never call it a fraud because everyone knows what's going on. I mean, you know, it's not, there's no fraudulent things going on. It's just a pyramid scheme, and you're betting that somebody's going to buy it. And you know, some people have been right. But the fundamentals make no sense.
Finally, do you think it has the trading volumes or the flows into crypto overall, do you think they have an effect even on the margin of equity prices here or around the world? Are traders
None.
Substituting attention?
No. I don't think they have any effect.
How to be a successful investor? The answer is stay with what you know. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to TV people, internet people. Just stay with what you know. If I told you you can only have 20 investments in your life, you would be very careful. You wouldn't be jumping in and out listening to hot tips every day, every month. You would stay with what you know and you would become a successful investor. Everybody watching this knows a lot about something, whether it's fashion or cars or sports or something. When you see something that you know is going to be successful and exciting, don't just say, oh, that's going to be great. Don't tell all you. Then you go and you do your research and you figure out how to and if you should invest and how to invest, and then you invest. You will know it long before I will, or long before other people in the investment community. You will also know when to sell, because you will know when something's going to change again. Nobody likes to hear it. Everybody wants a hot tip. Everybody wants to be rich this month. In those days, we did nothing but focus and concentrate and dig deep and dig deep and dig deep.